In general, each Japanese woodworker sorts the wood subjectively, within the context of their work and according to its intended use. Their classification system-based criteria are determined by their main concerns. As for Turner Imai Masataka, he divides the wood into softwood and hardwood. The type of wood will determine the cutting tools that will be used. According to him and most Japanese craftsmen, not all broadleaf trees are hardwoods. Rather, some of them are soft. Imai says that in his work, white-leaf Japanese magnolia and katsura trees are considered soft. However, they can also be considered hardwood. It depends on the field of work involved. He did not describe any conifers as being hard, and a sculptor named Tanaka Fumiaki, who uses the literal meanings of soft and hard to divide timber into softwood and hardwood, had a similar point of view. However, regarding coniferous trees, Tanaka's opinion diverged from that of Imai. He gave a detailed description of the coniferous trees that he considered to be hard. Even within the same genus of a coniferous tree, such as pine, there are differences. Japanese pines are still considered soft, while foreign pines and also cedar imported from Canada are considered hard. This might be because of the climate. As did Imai, he considered some broadleaf trees to be soft. In general, Japanese zelkova is a rather hard type of wood, but exceptions exist. Among zelkova types, there is one that is known for a wood pattern called rice bran grain. Wood with such a rice bran figuring is rather soft. As for the wood of katsura, he said, it is considered soft even if there are also hard pieces. The kinds of wood that I get for wood carving are katsura and magnolia. I use those the most. The expressions of hardwoods and softwoods are used literally by the traditional woodworkers in Japan, just as they are in Europe. Classification of wood as being soft or hardwood depends on individual notions of hard and soft. It can vary depending on the individual woodworker and the field in which he works. In other words, there is a strong relationship between the classification of wood and the requirements of the work. For the sculptor and turner, the hardness of the wood determines the kind of object that can be made and the tools involved. For them, these provide the criteria for their classification of wood. For Buddhist sculptor Mukiyoshi Yoboku, the priorities are different. He said, as Buddhist sculptors, our objective is to reveal the message of Buddhism through the medium of wood. He divides wood into two types, misogi, wood designated for Buddhist sculpture, and implicitly, non-misogi wood. Additionally, Muyashita Kenyuro used the term China wood to differentiate it from waboku, Japanese wood, a word that, even though he does not work with Japanese wood, expresses Muyashita's respect for it. Carpenter Hirose Takayuki divides timber into groups that reflect the uses he makes of it, which goes for beams, posts, and sills, or additionally, interior construction. These examples once again confirm that each woodworker classifies wood subjectively within the context of his work and according to the use he makes of the wood. The criteria on which their classification is based are determined by their main concerns. For sculptor Tanaka, the main concern is the hardness of the wood. For turner Imai, the balance between the hardness of the wood and his tools. For China wood cabinet maker Muyashita, the provenance of the timber. For Buddhist sculptor Mukuyoshi, the sacredness of the wood. And for carpenter Hirose, the role the timber will play in the building. Thus, it is evident that these classifications are context-bound, as each woodworker's classification system is intimately related to the specific nature of his work. It is of practical importance to its users as it divides timber into groups useful to the individual craftsman. The classifications made by Japanese woodworkers, particularly Mukuyoshi, who is concerned with a wood's sacred character, reflect an interaction between culture, cognitive processes, and the material world.
Cut, strike, shave, carve. Working opposite a tree with hundreds or thousands of years, while feeling the muku, or sacred tree, with one skin. A story is told with the blade. The chisel dances and glides along with the wood. Splinters of wood fly into the air, and the wood begins to dance.